In this video, I'm going to explain to you a super important concept that most people with MS have never had explained to them. It's called PIRA, or progression independent from relapse activity. Please don't turn away. I need you to hear this, and that starts right now. Howdy! Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between visits, and it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. Today, I wanted to discuss the concept of PIRA, progression independent from relapse activity. It is a concept which has been in the medical literature only recently. It is not something that I commonly hear MS doctors talking to patients about in clinic. It is not something that is top of mind, and it should be. And I think it explains a lot. When people with MS worsen in their neurological status, when they develop or accrue neurological disability, when they lose neurological functioning, they can really do it one of two ways. They can either have a clinical attack where they lose a function, and I'll use the example of an optic neuritis where they go blind because their optic nerve doesn't work. And then after maybe steroids and some time, vision recovers partially. So they used to be 20/20 in that eye, and now they're 20/200. They're legally blind, but they can still see. And that person in this example has accrued disability because they've incompletely recovered from an attack. It turns out that is probably not the most common way that people with MS develop disability. Most commonly, they're developing disability independent from relapse activity. So independent from that attack, they're slowly getting worse. A guy named Gavin Giovannoni, who works at Bart's MS, has talked a lot in his blog about the concept of smoldering MS, where someone's not having an attack per se, but they're slowly getting worse. He actually uses the visual imagery of a shredder set on low, slowly chewing through your brain tissue. And I hate to say it, but that's pretty damn accurate. There was a clinical trial done recently, and in this trial, they randomized people to either receive Rebif or Ocrevus. And they ran them through a trial for several years, looking at their attacks and their disability. And when the trial was all over, they did something really statistically cool. They went back to the data, and they looked at each individual patient's trajectory. They removed relapse-associated disability. So in other words, that person that lost vision and then got some of it back, they removed that statistically from the graph. And what they were left with underneath was PIRA, progression that was independent from associated relapses. What they found was really telling. Both groups, the Rebif-treated group and the Ocrevus-treated group, both experienced PIRA. Over the course of the trial, both groups got worse separate from attacks. Now, mind you, these are relapsing patients. These are not progressive patients. But the people that were treated with the highly effective Ocrevus developed less PIRA. They got less disabled than the people that were on Rebif. So what can we learn from this? Well, first of all, we can make an obvious comment that some drugs are better than others. But we can make a deeper comment that the concept of relapses and then remission is BS. The concepts of if you're not having an attack, you're okay is simply false. So you might be thinking, great. You're telling me that I'm getting worse even when I'm not having attacks, so all is lost. Not true. Understanding that there's different kinds of ways of accruing disability empowers us, and it helps us understand why we have to go above and beyond just taking a medicine. Yes, taking an MS anti-inflammatory, any of the 22 different FDA-approved ones here in the United States, is really, really important because when you have an attack that causes neurological damage, you're causing brain damage and you may not recover. And that structural lesion will wear out over the next 15 years and contribute to progression down the line. But now we're introducing this other idea that there's in the background this smoldering progression independent from relapse activity. There are things that we can do to help that. For example, let's make sure that your MS medicine does have some data suggesting it can slow disability. Let's make sure that your MS medicine is good at slowing brain volume loss. These are important things. We should not just accept a medicine that can only show good data decreasing relapses in MRI. We need more than that. Beyond medicines, we have to enter into the concepts of brain health. There are behaviors, activities, things we eat, things we drink, activities that we do, which can help us allow the brain to age naturally and not in an accelerated fashion. Cardiovascular risk factors make people with MS get neurologically worse faster. Think about that. It's another thing attacking the holiest of holies. It's another thing in accelerating brain volume loss. If you can control high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, if you can combat inactivity, if you can fight against morbid obesity, if you can be moderate in your alcohol consumption, and if you can avoid lighting carbon-based things on fire and smoking them, exercising is almost magical. And people impacted by MS that exercise as part of their lifestyle, they become disabled slower than people that don't. We need you to embrace a lifestyle of exercise and healthy, clean eating and avoiding smoking and genuinely embracing brain health. Because the goal here is to allow your brain to age naturally. What do you think about the concept? Does it help you better understand the disease state? And does it empower you to be active in pursuing brain health? Please share with me and the rest of this village down in the section below, and I really do look forward to reading what you have to say. My name's Aaron Boster, and thank you for learning about MS with me. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing and ringing the notifications bell. And until my next video or my next live stream or the next time I see you in clinic, be safe and take care.